views expressed on this program are those of the hosts, guests, and callers, and are not necessarily those of this station, its management, or other advertisers. You're listening to Transformation Talk Radio.
Voices of Women is a talk radio show that gives voice to the personal stories of women. It will inspire women and enlighten men to follow their dreams and create positive changes in their lives. Whether the audience listens to best-selling authors or a layperson like themselves, they'll realize there are others with similar experiences and feelings to their own. This show will give women tools they can use every day, which will empower them to step out of their boxes and create the changes they desire in their life. Kris inspires women to find their voices, speak up, and become leaders of their own life. Everyone has their gifts to share with the world, and it's time for women to work together to bring honor and respect to the feminine voice, which is within all people, men and women. Topics include personal growth, spirituality, creativity, leadership, and divine feminine. Now here's your host, Kris Steinnes.
Welcome to Voices of Women. Boy, what a painful week for our country. I'm just, I really want to spend a moment. Just my heart goes out to everyone who's impacted by these series of events. And I know I'm feeling like others. This thought, of, another one, another black man shot by policemen, and then another one, and then another horrible tragedy of several policemen killed, which was at a peaceful demonstration. So, it's just, I think we just get disheartened. And I want to talk a little bit because I think it's important to say that, yes, we all Americans, we support Black Lives Matter. And one of the reasons I just want to kind of give my background of my work is empower women. And so that's to raise the women's stature to be equal to men. And so it may look like we're disregarding men's issues, but until women are treated equally and abuse, rape and sex trade, all that thing, everything else is obliterated. There needs to be a focus on raising the respect and honor of the feminine until there's not a difference in how the genders are treated in our society. And I think it's the same kind of focus of Black Lives Matter to raise their lives to be equal with all, because until they are, there is not equality and freedom in our country. And we can't say all lives matter until that is the truth. And so there is a focus of Black Lives Matter, and we have so much work to do. A minister at my church, at the Church for Center for Spiritual Living in Seattle, small church, Amazing Grace, last Sunday he said that we need to match our outrage at these issues that disturb us with optimism. The same amount of energy goes into optimism that we have the ability to heal, to create solutions while not disregarding our outrage that what is happening is wrong and inhumane. And I just want to call for a short, quick moment of silence for the healing that needs to happen and for all those who are suffering this week. Okay, thank you. I know it's not good to have dead air on a radio show, but I think it's important to take times for silence at these important times in our lives and in what our country goes through. So today, my guest is Carrie L’Esperance. She's an artist, a writer, a certified iridologist, and permaculture designer. She offers workshops at a rustic retreat and nature preserve in Northern California. She's the author of The Seasonal Detox Diet and has spent more than 35 years studying the healing systems of the world's culture. She lives in San Francisco, and she now has a new book that's called Soul Breathing, Spiritual Light, and the Art of Self-Mastery. It shows how to cultivate higher consciousness with specific techniques and breathing exercises so that we can develop that self-mastery. So welcome, Carrie.
Thank you so much, Kris, and thank you for the beautiful moment of silence. That was very powerful.
Yeah, I think it's a very emotional time right now.
Yes, it's emotional and it's shocking, and you wonder, where is it coming from? Why is it happening? What's really happening in the world? Why is it happening, and what can we do about it? And that was one of the reasons that I wrote Soul Breathing, because I really felt that there has been a lot of disconnect between people in regard to how to live And so to me, we have to study more about who we really are as human beings and what we're really capable of, and the value of the human being, the value of the soul, the value of the spirit, the power that lies within that beautiful gift that we've been given through existence and life. So we see that life is being disrespected and disregarded in a way that is very alarming, and it's imperative that people begin to learn about the invisible energies that underlie and support existence, that support life. In my first book, I explored, because I was younger, I was in my 20s, I explored the difference between the physical, the outer body and the inner body. And the seasonal detox diet explored all of the oldest healing systems in the world and represented the best of those. And it taught people how to think about what goes on inside of the body. We all know what happens on the outside when our hair is dirty or we need a shower. You know, we need to do something to maintain the outer surface of the body. And so detoxing got people thinking about the inner body. And fortunately, that book helped to ignite the billion-dollar detox movement that we see today in the world, which is thrilling. So people did a great job grabbing onto that ball and running with it. And I began to ask myself after a certain amount of time, what is next? Because it's very difficult to be balanced, to maintain balance in an unbalanced world. You can detox and you can feel wonderful and you can be healthy and happy, but then everybody else around you is so unbalanced and everything seems so chaotic and unbalanced. How do you, what's the next step is what I asked myself. And Soul Breathing came about as a book that actually has taken a lifetime to write, and it's based on experience, so it's a very powerful book. It's based on a tremendous amount of research, and I think right now, in regard to the place that we're at with technology, it's imperative for people to learn more about how the body actually maintains its balance in physical third world dimensional existence, that there's an underlying dimensional fourth and fifth and sixth and seventh dimensional body that people aren't thinking about. And so this is very, very important to learn about, especially now, especially for our children, because the technology that we have is definitely imposing upon these invisible energies and affecting people in ways that are unprecedented, that we have never been exposed to before. It's affecting human beings. It's affecting animals. It's affecting the environment.
Well, before you go on, I want to ask, What are the effects so that we can identify, you know, because a lot of times it's so subtle. We're not aware of it, of how it's affecting. And I, with your research, you know, how is it impacting us?
Well, there's a fascinating gentleman, an Egyptian doctor, Dr. Ibrahim Karim, who has created a science around radiesthesia, which is the study of frequency. And he has created a science called biogeometry, which I have been a student of. And he claims that the electromagnetic frequencies from, let's say, for example, a cell phone, those microwaves that are coming through that cell phone are 1,000 times more powerful than the human cell. And they scramble the energy of the human body and the energy matrix of the human body. They scramble the synapses connections in the brain. They affect the auric shield around the body. They scramble it and make the energy chaotic. And when we think about how we are now blanketing the planet with cell towers and the whole atmosphere is changing because of the radiations that are emanating, the invisible radiations that are emanating in the air. There's a professor in Sweden at Lund University, Dr. Leif Selford, that has stated that the voluntary use of cell phones is the biggest experiment on humanity in history. So we see that these devices are being marketed at a very rapid rate, but there doesn't seem to be any acknowledgement of those who are concerned about the health issues. They are the people who are concerned and who are bringing up issues about regarding health, especially with children, are being ignored. And so I think we have to take things into our own hands and educate ourselves and begin to recognize that the energy that is being put into the environment all around us at an unprecedented scale is bio-incompatible with the human frequency. So there are ways to make biocompatible technology, and it's we have to demand that the technology be made more compatible with life in general.
Yeah, and that takes an educational process. Like I think, well, at least some people are aware of, you know, cell phones to your ear are not good for your brain, you know, and that, that you know, having that much whatever that emits into you impacts you. And I mean, I've been aware of that for several years, and people I know are aware of that. Maybe not everybody is, but I think it's about, you know, educating people so that we know what the impact is. And so that then we can look at other alternatives, and because we're pretty brilliant of creating new things and finding things that, like you say, could be bioidentical with work with our physicality. Well, this is Kris Steinnes. We're going to take a short break and come back. We'll talk more with Carrie L’Esperance about soul breathing.
How would you like increased health and vitality? How would you like to avoid the onset of disease as well as slow the aging process? This is all possible through a simple, safe, and natural process. Every day we are either moving toward wellness or away from wellness.
Hi, I'm Mary Jane Mack. I'd like to be your partner in achieving optimal health. Contact me now at MaryJaneMack.com or call 425-392-0659. Visit MaryJaneMack.com.
Kris Steinnes is a spiritual leader and healer and teaches a course on how you can transform your life through a meditation and healing system that will manifest your spirit's dreams. She manifested the Women of Wisdom Conference, the Women of Wisdom book, and this radio show. And she can show you how to change your life too. Are you ready? Visit the website and contact her at voicesofwomentoday.com. That's voicesofwomentoday.com.
Do you want to achieve your goals? Do you want to strengthen relationships with others? Do you want to improve your financial status? Colette Marie Steffen is partnering with Mark Kettenbach to bring you an energetic upgrade online experience launching in April. Unfold and develop your full potential. Visit energeticupgrade.com today for more information. That's energeticupgrade.com.
The doctor is in. Tune in to the hit show, The Psychic Love Doctor, with host Deborah Lee. Deborah's life-affirming, highly perceptive reading method has taught Deborah how to zero in on specific problems with relationships, career pursuits, and current roadblocks to success and happiness. Join Deborah Fridays at 2 p.m. Pacific and for a special broadcast the second Thursday of every month at 11 a.m. Pacific on TransformationTalkRadio.com.
If you're one of the millions of Americans suffering from anxiety, you probably know how powerless and out of control this emotion can make you feel. This is why it is so important to remember that anxiety is created by your mind, which means that you can learn to use your mind to uncreate it. Hello, my name is Dr. Friedman Schaub. My award-winning book, The Fear and Anxiety Solution, provides you with a step-by-step breakthrough process to understand and resolve the root causes of your anxiety and build a solid foundation of confidence and inner peace. If you're ready to take your power back, visit thefearandanxietysolution.com.
Order your copy of Dr. Friedemann Schaub's The Fear and Anxiety Solution today. Visit thefearandanxietysolution.com for more information.
Welcome back to Voices of Women. I am speaking with Carrie L’Esperance and on her book, Soul Breathing, Spiritual Light, and the Art of Self-Mastery. So let's begin with, what is soul breathing, Carrie?
Well, soul breathing, a lot of people think it's breathing exercises, but in my book, soul breathing is actually the unification of the surface mind or the intellect with the deeper wisdom of the soul. And we see in the world that people operate mainly with the surface mind, which is also opens us to an aspect of what we call the ego. And the ego can be either pure, it's the part of people that know that they exist, or it can be false, which is the ego that believes that it's separate and that, you know, demands attention and will create all kinds of stories around itself to, shall we say, create its own reality. And so soul breathing is actually when you connect the surface mind, which is the intellect, with the deeper wisdom of the soul, you get what's called whole brain thinking. And what is whole brain thinking? Well, when the intellect and the spirit work together, then the mind follows the spirit rather than the mind just being led or influenced by outer influences all around it. We see many influences from the time that we're born with family and culture and school and many, you know, institutional religions and ways of living. And so how does a person become who they really are? And it is, it emanates from the soul. The soul is the inner teacher that is imbued in every human being. And it's the deeper aspect of the self that oftentimes goes unnoticed, uncultivated, and it's undernourished oftentimes. So soul breathing is being aware that there is a deeper intelligence within the individual that we connect with and align with and then follow.
So it's interesting because one of the statements I pulled from you information is reaching higher states of consciousness requires calling upon the transformative power of the soul, that it's not handed to us, but it's earned. So I'd love for you to share, you know, why you say it's earned and how do we earn it?
Well, each soul has a unique resonance, and it's rather like a fingerprint. Each person has a different fingerprint, and each soul has a unique resonance within it. So that resonance is, it has to be connected with. There's a higher frequency that is, the soul is seated with spirit, which is a higher frequency. And so it does not emerge unbidden. It is a process of seeking and aligning with and resonating with. So the soul will attempt to communicate with the individual oftentimes, and it really does depend on the individual's ability to recognize the subtle energies of the soul, and the energies of the soul are very subtle. So usually people that are very addicted to distraction They have to be busy constantly. They are overwhelmed with certain processes in their life, perhaps addictions or relationships, things that take people far away from their deeper silence within. And so in order to earn the soul's communicatory aspect, a person really has to begin to align with it in a way that harmonizes with the resonance of the soul. And that involves cleaning up the diet. That involves doing some cleansing of the body. It involves taking a certain amount of time within your life to create silence around you and connecting with nature so that you can receive the subtle energies. And what you begin to do when this happens is you begin to create a resonance all on your own. So the higher frequency that you can create that emanates from your both your mind and your body is what connects you to higher frequencies of intelligence and beings that will help you with your process and your soul contract. So everybody comes in to the world with a soul contract. They have a destiny that they're trying to achieve, and the soul is your main guide for that process. And so when we get off track, the way to get back on track and what we're trying to get back on track with is the resonance of the soul, the fingerprint that we came in with, our original super self that doesn't die and is here to do something very important. That's what we want to align with in our lives. That's how we learn how to live.
Well, and it sounds like what you're saying, too, is like through meditative practices, or it's that being still and listening. You know, like you said, we're all so busy and bombarded with media and our busy lives and overwhelmed that. And it's we often talk about it on my show, all the various people who come on the show and their ways of doing it. But that getting to that still place. And because you're not going to touch in what you're saying, you're not going to touch into that soul or that higher consciousness of yourself unless you do quiet your mind.
Yes. And so when you're operating just with the intellect, with the surface mind, and you're operating on a surface value, you're basically you're operating with a partial equation of intelligence. And so when you have a great way, I guess, to describe it would be, let's just imagine the two strands of information of DNA, the spiral strands. There's two interlocking strands. So you could imagine that matter would be one strand of DNA and spirit would be the second strand of DNA. It's matter would be the child and spirit would be the parent. And so when the two strands of information combine to make one, then you have whole brain thinking, basically. And what we see happening, you know, what you were talking about earlier when you opened the show, the things that are happening in the world are happening because people are operating on a surface level. They're not fully integrating, and they're not operating with whole brain thinking. So once you begin to operate with whole brain thinking, things begin to flow in a different direction, away from violence, away from chaos, away from ignorance, away from destruction. This is what we're talking about. And so, you know, right now, I don't know if people understand that what's happening on the planet is the most important threshold in recorded history. And it's just imperative that people begin to go deeper and study about who they really are and practice and align with the soul and the spirit that inhabits the soul. And if we can do that, we can change the world. It's very difficult to change other people. It's very difficult to change the world, but we can certainly change ourselves. We can certainly work on ourselves. And there's really no one that can change another person's consciousness for them. That is the responsibility of the individual. So that in itself is a tremendous amount of power right there. If you think about just consciousness on its own, consciousness is the most powerful force in the universe. Consciousness is what is between the spaces in the atom. Consciousness is what fills space in the universe. And I think that this is what people haven't been taught, that they have a cosmic mind to draw from. They have a spiritual intelligence that is beyond the body, that is beyond the third dimension. It's the part of us that doesn't die. So I think that anyone out there who has had an out-of-body experience knows what I'm talking about. I don't know if you've ever had an out-of-body experience, Kris. Have you ever had an out-of-body experience? It's a personal question.
Well, in ways, not in the sense of, I've been aware of it, of having experiences, not like a near-death experience or that kind of out-of-body, but just in a deep meditation situation, probably. But anyway, and we're right at our break time again. And when we come back, I think this all relates to another question that we want to talk about is defining and developing self-mastery, because that's kind of what you're talking about, you know, yes. The self-mastery to achieve this higher consciousness and align, be in alignment with your soul and your soul's purpose and all that. Okay, so we're going to take a short break and we'll come back and talk more with Carrie L’Esperance.
Ready to experience Truth Talk Radio with host Deb Acker. Tune in to Truth Talk Radio each Wednesday at 3 p.m. Pacific on TransformationTalkRadio.com to illuminate the truth in your daily life as you experience life, love, and abundance from a whole new perspective. This hit show will leave you feeling lighter and bring you into a place of infinite possibilities every day in every way. Visit TruthTalkRadioShow.com for upcoming transformative topics and guests.
Tune in to The Jen Royster Show, intuitive guidance to inspire your life, each Thursday at 8 a.m. Pacific and 11 a.m. Eastern on TransformationTalkRadio.com. This amazing show is an inspirational hour that will take you on an epic metaphysical journey to discover the spiritual approach to life's greatest challenges. Dr. Jen is an internationally known intuitive counselor, spiritual teacher, and energy healer. Call in for intuitive readings and visit JenRoyster.com for more information.
Awaken to your radiant, authentic self. For over 15 years, Soul Purpose Advocate Nancy Monson has been focused on leading change in the lives of those looking to live their true purpose. She is devoted to supporting people in living a soul-directed life every day. Let Nancy help you overcome fear, worry, and doubt. Visit everydayspirituality.com to learn how Nancy can be your Soul Purpose Advocate.
Are you searching? Looking for a sign? A message you need to hear? From the great unknown? From the most mysterious place that is the most familiar to your soul and the depths of who you are? The universe put someone here to talk to, someone God gave a blessing to that you may find insight with. TheAngelLady.net. 1-800-323-1790.
Kris Steinnes is a spiritual leader and healer and teaches a course on how you can transform your life through a meditation and healing system that will manifest your spirit's dreams. She manifested the Women of Wisdom Conference, the Women of Wisdom book, and this radio show. And she can show you how to change your life too. Are you ready? Visit the website and contact her at voicesofwomentoday.com. That's voicesofwomentoday.com.
Have you ever tried to make lifestyle changes but had difficulty following through? Imagine what it would be like to get up each morning with energy, clarity, and motivation to tackle the day. If you want to get past limiting barriers that are preventing you from living your best life, join holistic health and wellness coach T. Carrie Mitchell each month on The Dr. Pat Show. Or visit lifestyle120.com today and start to receive the personal attention you deserve.
Welcome back to Voices of Women. We're talking about soul breathing and the art of self-mastery with Carrie L’Esperance. And Carrie, first before we go on, I want you to give your website where people can find out more about you and about your books.
Oh, sure. Thank you. It's CarrieL’Esperance.com. And my name is spelled CarrieL’Esperance.
Great. Yeah. So be sure to everybody can check out her books and the work that she does. So we were just touching on out-of-body experiences. And so I know we want to just kind of wrap that up a little bit of what that and how that relates to raising our consciousness and also the art of self-mastery and how we can achieve that.
Yes. And Kris, I think that any of your listeners who have ever had out-of-body experiences, they understand exactly what I mean when I say that once you have one, you recognize that you exist beyond the body, that the body is a third-dimensional entity, and then consciousness is in a higher dimension. It's in the fourth dimension, which has also been proven by science. And so once you have an out-of-body experience, it just tremendously expands your consciousness, and you begin to realize how focused we are on our own little worlds here in the physical environment, you know, with survival and with getting everything done that has to be done. And, you know, it can be very overwhelming. So when you have this expansive experience of an outer body experience, it really does demand that you explore the deeper inner self much more. It's very inspiring, and it also helps you to understand that we're so much more than our bodies, and how very important consciousness is, and how very important it is to learn how to direct our consciousness for quality of life. So these things all begin to become in the forefront of life rather than physical survival, physical maintenance, going to the plastic surgeon, you know, worrying about whether or not you look good enough or you're thin enough or all these things that they put on people that they waste their time on. It's much deeper than that. And so out of body experiences can be life changing.
Oh, yes. So true. And even just in meditate, like I was sharing in my experience, meditative practices of a lot of things happen in dream state, you know, that yes. take you to that out of body, which you may think, well, that was a weird dream, you know, those kinds of things.
Yes.
And it does take you in that other realities. Well, in self-mastery, you know, one of the things that you have in your book, or you do have some practices and things. And one of the things is an affirmation for alignment.
Yes. Well, so, you know, self-mastery is all about worshiping the true principle that flows through all of humanity as being the indwelling divine God principle of light and life. So when we direct ourselves towards self-mastery, we recognize that really alone that we can do very little by ourselves. But if we unite with our spiritual force, which is basically the force of good that's seeking to manifest itself, and we choose to achieve in this way, then we begin to align with the divine in oneself. So that basically is very simple to do, and I give an affirmation for alignment in soul breathing. If you'd like it, I can read it for people.
It's very short, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Sure. It's a nice time to close your eyes and just take it in. Basically, the affirmation for alignment says, I am ready to learn. I trust in spirit to guide me now. I willfully choose to align with what is beyond my physical boundaries and barriers. I may have been inattentive for a long time, and I am now opening my heart and mind in reverence of spirit's great and guiding light. I am grateful for all that I may give and for all that I may receive. I am open to spiritual direction toward the benefit of inner vision, which is my lifeline to my true work in the world. I align my body, my heart, and my mind with the spiritual assets that eternally abide with me and help me to know the truth. I am in deep gratitude for this profound gift of love. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Well, thank you. Actually, that's a great thing just to read to yourself every day and start the day with, setting up this alignment, like your physicality, your mind, your life is in alignment with your soul's purpose.
Yes, and it's very simple. And there's a short, that was the longer affirmation for alignment. There's a short daily affirmation that just basically says, I surrender to the loving guidance and direction of the higher mind of creation. Thank you for this day that I may be of service to the light within me. With all of my heart and devotion, that I will know my way in life through alignment with the higher realms of wisdom and love. Thank you. So that's mm-hmm. much shorter.
Mm-hmm.
And, these are things that are so powerful because they begin to set up a resonance, a frequency in the body and in the mind once you begin to recognize the power of it. Because what is resonance? It's a vibratory frequency. And what is frequency but energy? And what is energy but information? So when we begin to resonate with higher frequencies of energy, we begin to receive higher frequencies of information. And that's what soul breathing is all about. That's the attitude and stance that it's vital that we begin to cultivate this in our lives now, probably more so than ever in history, because it's no secret to most people that we're at a critical threshold, not just with all the things that are happening on the planet, but also things that are happening beyond the planet that most people may not have experience with. And there's a great need to understand what's really happening in the world right now, why it's happening, and what we can do about it, how we can empower ourselves. So soul breathing is dedicated to all of these things, and it's a very, very important task that we have at hand now. And I wanted to give people a tool. So some things that we can talk about in regard to mastery that we see in the world today is one of the things is that a true master is always in the present awareness of being. And a master will not claim to be capable of achieving any more than what the ordinary person is capable of achieving. So therefore, a true master will never claim to be a master. And we see many things in the world today that are, misleading people. There's a lot of information out there. There's people and beings claiming that they're masters. The only true master that anyone will ever meet is the master within, because the master within is the original seed of creative spirit that we were birthed from. And we all have this great gift to work with. Self-mastery also encompasses understanding the vibratory frequencies that of unmanifest substance, you know, to bring forth assistance from the spiritual realms to the physical realm. And so self-mastery is a life of service. It's not a life of being self-centered. It's a life of being of service to both spirit, the spiritual realm, and the physical realm. And so, you know, self-mastery encompasses how to focus and concentrate and direct the vibratory frequencies of the mind that transmute spirit to matter and matter to spirit. And it's accomplished by working with the conscious processes of mind to raise and lower vibratory frequencies. And basically, you know, this is how Jesus, for example, fed the masses and walked on water. And so what Jesus did is an example of what many of the advanced masters have the ability to do. And I give some wonderful stories in soul breathing in regard to certain experiences that explorers have had with coming across these masters. They demonstrate the same abilities that Jesus did, and Jesus tried to explain to people that all people have these abilities. And so this is the direction that we are destined to go in. Self-mastery is where the world is supposed to be headed, rather than being overwhelmed with technological overlords or technological vibratory frequencies that are going to overwhelm the health and the magnetic balance of the planet.
And we have to take a break, but yes, sure. This whole thing on self-mastery is a very critical aspect of and aspect of your book. So this is Kris Steinnes. We're going to take a quick break and come back and talk more with Carrie L’Esperance.
Kris Steinnes is a spiritual leader and healer and teaches a course on how you can transform your life through a meditation and healing system that will manifest your spirit's dreams. She manifested the Women of Wisdom Conference, the Women of Wisdom book, and this radio show. And she can show you how to change your life too. Are you ready? Visit the website and contact her at voicesofwomentoday.com. That's voicesofwomentoday.com.
Wow. Hey, everyone. Welcome. Welcome to the Dr. Pat Show. This is Talk Radio to Thrive By. I'm telling you, I got to pinch myself some days, because when each of us gets called to do something that we so not thought was in our wheelhouse to do for a purpose that's so much greater than us, we get to show up and shine.
If you would like to show up and shine on the Dr. Pat Show as a co-host or sponsor, send us an email to inspire@thedrpatshow.com.
Are you ready for a game changer? Sarah Westall is bringing you Business Game Changers Radio. Sarah brings you leading experts, visionaries, and newsmakers who provide the best commentary on big issues and cutting-edge innovations. Sarah's 20 years as a business executive will help you think like an entrepreneur with expertise, energy, and attitude. Tune in to Business Game Changers Mondays at noon Pacific, 3 Eastern on TransformationTalkRadio.com.
get ready to rid yourself of all that is weighing you down and holding you back from living the life you want for yourself. Coming Clean, The Art of Transparency with Catherine Moss is a hit show for women in recovery who are ready to live life on purpose. Tune in and let Catherine help you live your truth one day at a time. Live each Tuesday, 9 a.m. Pacific on TransformationTalkRadio.com.
Get into it for 2016. Do you want more prosperity, clarity, energy, and balance in your life? Join Lynn Brown now for one of her amazing workshops, each focusing on a key part of living your best life. For more information and to register for one of these amazing workshops, visit LynnBrownEvent.com. That's LynnBrownEvent.com. And get into it this 2016 with Lynn Brown.
Hi, this is Leslie Fontaine, and my show is Sheer Alchemy on TransformationTalkRadio.com. When we're bogged down with our emotions, the hardships that plague us in our relationships, at work, our finances, we literally can't see the higher plane where we could be operating from. Tune in to Leslie Fontaine, Sheer Alchemy on TransformationTalkRadio.com.
Welcome back to Voices of Women. I'm Kris Steinnes, and I'm talking with Carrie L’Esperance, author of Soul Breathing, Spiritual Light, and the Art of Self-Mastery. So we've been talking a lot about a lot of things and self-mastery, and I think, one of the things that you talk a lot about, Carrie, in your book is, and you've touched on, is how technology impacts us, the cell phones and cell towers and all this. And some people kind of poo-poo, those ideas, but just because I probably a lack of understanding or just think they don't feel impacted by that. But in your book, you have a lot of to say about technology severely reducing humanity's natural abilities and our spiritual powers. And so I'd love for you to talk about that and then how we can counter that, how we can protect ourselves.
Yes, that is a very important subject, Kris. Thank you for asking that question. It's really technology isn't really the problem. It's the way that technology is being used, and technology can be made to be safer. You know, there's a French geobiologist who her name is Regina Martino. She wrote a wonderful book called Shungite. And shungite is a silver black stone found only in one place on Earth, the Russian part of Karelia. And she explains in her book that basically, shungite is one of the only stones or minerals in the world that will neutralize she calls it the left torsion field of electromagnetic radiation. So in her book, she explains that the radiation of electromagnetic frequencies is a principal source of left torsion fields. And torsion fields are transmitted by electromagnetic waves. And left torsion fields are very harmful to health, and they are especially detrimental to our overall energetic balance, and that includes the physical, the energetic, emotional, and psychic and spiritual realms. So basically, she explains that, shungite will help transform a left torsion influence to a right torsion influence. And this helps us to reconnect with homeostasis and the natural energy of life. We're children of nature, not technology. And so it is essential that the human vital energy field be rebalanced when the integrity of the body and the brain is being violated by techno pollution the way that it is today, especially when the major portion of one's time is spent in close range of technological devices. I think people are getting too used to resonating maybe with dissonant technology. When we no longer resonate with nature, we experience dissonance, and it's an unbalanced state of being. And electronics are designed to create dissonant static that jams the harmonic human frequency. And it in turn causes the inability to get beyond a certain frequency rate. So one of the glands in the brain that is very important for connecting with spiritual frequencies is the pineal gland. And we know that the pineal gland has a very difficult time discerning between daylight and the electromagnetic frequencies that are all around us now. And, you know, consequently, people are having a lot of trouble sleeping. They go to sleep, but then they wake feeling not rested. And I think people are starting, you know, we know that some of these energies can actually alter human DNA. So I would
say
that.
Yeah, they even say now to not, you know, be on your computer before you go to bed. Impacts, you know, impacts your ability to sleep and all that.
Yes, and so we have to recognize that we're at a point where it's crucial that we understand how to neutralize the health dangers of radiation exposure. And we are electromagnetic creatures. Life is electromagnetic, and you know, if we wish to evolve and go to higher places of consciousness, we have to recognize that modern technology, it has to be altered to harmonize with the well-being of all sentient life in general. So this is a very, very important area. We have to wake up and we have to begin to protect ourselves. And if we're not going to see these important reports on the nightly news, then we have to take responsibility and learn about what's really happening and why. So this is another aspect that the book addresses.
Mm-hmm. So what do you recommend then to protect yourself? Like, you know, many of us know about our auric field and having shields that protect. So what is your recommendation for people for protection?
Well, given the state of technology, it's unnatural frequencies. We have to minimize the radiation around the body. And so we have to incorporate ways of minimizing how much time we spend with technology and begin to connect more with the earth. And another thing that affects us greatly is our attentions and how we direct our consciousness. The misappropriation of energy in regard to our imagined imperfections. We have to stop focusing on our imagined imperfections and begin to recognize and align with what we do have to work with, which is our absolutely extraordinary spiritual gifts. So we have to we can't allow ourselves lengthy concentration on negative qualities and conditions and things like deep-seated fears and insecurities. Mind and body work together. The body needs the mind and the mind needs the spirit. So these are two very important areas. Protect the mind and focus. Protect the body and focus the mind.
Yes, very important. Well, and we're at the end of our show. A last short parting words of wisdom for our audience?
Sure. A lot of people think that they don't have time, but I would say that to begin to engrave spirituality into their life processes, you can begin with gratitude. So if you can just begin with gratitude in any way, shape, and form, even if you're getting into your car and driving to your destiny, you can ask spirit to help protect you and achieve your goals and have a safe journey. That's just one quick way, you know, that you can begin to engrave spirituality in your life, but begin
with gratitude.
Yeah.
That's great. So thank you so much for being on the show today, Carrie.
Oh, my pleasure. Thank you so much for having me. God bless you all.
Yes. Well, everybody can check out her book, Soul Breathing, Spiritual Light and the Art of Self-Mastery. Our website is Carrie, C-A-R-R-I-E, L'Esperance.com. So this is Kris Steinnes, and I'm the founder of Woman of Wisdom Foundation. And we are now planning our 25th annual conference. It's going to be February 16th to the 20th. And we're very excited. We're going to be doing some very special things this year, changing up our format, getting more community things going. We're very excited. And so sign up for our newsletter to find out more about it at www.womenofwisdom.org. And if you want to participate, if you're in the Seattle area and want to participate in creating, we do co-create, and we have a wonderful committee. And if you want to looking for a group of women to be with, contact me at wow@womenofwisdom.org. And also check out my book, Woman of Wisdom, Empowering the Dreams and Spirit of Woman. It's stories and inspirational words of many women who participate in Woman of Wisdom, our speakers, our artists, our creators, lots of stories around the divine feminine. And you can check that out on womanofwisdom.org as well. It benefits Woman of Wisdom, which is a nonprofit organization. So so glad to have had this hour with you on Voices of Women. Next week, I'll be talking to Diane Givens. She's a Seattle artist and designer of the Angelic Reality Attunement Cards. So have a great weekend, everybody.
You've been listening to Voices of Women with Kris Steinnes. Tune in each Friday at 1 p.m. Pacific Time, 4 p.m. Eastern Time for Voices of Women Today. Radio with Kris Steinnes.